According to the Maine Department of Transportation Crash Unit, so far this year, there have been more than 230 crashes, including one or more tractor trailer or semi trucks in Maine.
And most of the time, the fault in those crashes is not with the truck drivers. News Center Maine's Hannah Dineen is live in Portland tonight to explain. Hannah.
Well, hey, Amanda, if you look out over the Maine Turnpike today or any day recently, it takes only about every few seconds or so, and you see another big commercial truck driving down the turnpike. And those trucks, I'm told, they are fairly easy to drive these days as they have all this new technology. That is until passenger vehicles unexpectedly get in their way.
From the driver's seat of a tractor trailer, a close call. Other days, the drivers aren't so lucky.
What we're finding is people get too comfortable around commercial motor vehicles.
Scott Clark has been in the trucking industry for 27 years.
When our drivers lose their stopping distance, they have a decision to make really quickly.
And no options in that split-second decision are good ones. Veer off the road going at full speed, or hit the car in front of them and possibly kill someone.
That's what's really tough. We want our team members to come home safe every night.
According to Maine State Police, in nearly 57% of crash fatalities in Maine involving a commercial vehicle, the passenger vehicle plays a role. Lieutenant Aaron Hayden says that's higher than in most states.
The percentage of passenger cars having a negative effect with a commercial vehicle is higher statistically in Maine than it is in other places.
Lieutenant Hayden says that's in part because of more distractions in the car and more cars on the road today. Also,
there's a lot of people that growing up, they're not around big trucks and buses and things like that anymore, and they really don't understand the stopping distances.
In terms of stopping distance, a normal passenger vehicle going 65 miles per hour will need about the length of a football field, around 300 feet, to stop. A fully loaded commercial truck going the same speed needs about twice that distance.
These drivers have a very, very tough job.
So truck drivers are asking all of us to help make their job easier and the road safer by giving them some space.
We just need people not to hover around large commercial motor vehicles, try to get beyond them, in front of them, or behind them.
And always a good reminder for your teen driver. According to the World Health Organization, injuries suffered on the road are the leading cause of death among people between the ages of 10 and 24. If you want to learn more about safe driving around buses and trucks, head to our website for some resources. In Portland, Hannah Dineen, Pat and Amanda, back to you.
Thank you, Hannah.